Stony Ridge, after this chestnut mare, been chasing her for weeks. Well, I'd catch a glimpse of her every once in a while, taking her meal, bathing. Fine lady. This one day I happened to be real close to her, and I saw her standing over there. So I snuck up on her nice and easy, got my rope out, and I flung it in the air.
I'm gonna catch that horse if I can. And when I do, I'll give her my brand. And we'll be friends for life. She'll be just like a wife. I'm going to catch that horse if I can.
And I got her, and I'm pulling on her, and she's pulling back like this mule going up a ladder. And I take a choice and I jump right up on her. Damned if I don't land right on top of her. And she takes off, running up onto the ridge, higher than I've ever been before. She's running along just fine, till she stops and something spooked her. It's a sidewinder all coiled and ready to strike. She doesn't know what to do for a second, but then she jumps off the edge, me holding on. Above the hills,
Buck's first day on the Dyea Beach was like a nightmare. Every hour was filled with shock and surprise. He had been suddenly jerked from the heart of civilization and flung into the heart of things primordial. No lazy, sun-kissed life was this, with nothing to do but loaf and be bored. Here was neither peace, nor rest, nor a moment's safety. All was confusion and action, and every moment life and limb were in peril. There was imperative need to be constantly alert, for these dogs and men were not town dogs and men. They were savages, all of them, who knew no law but the law of club and fang.
Red thing below us, coming up real fast, and it's our reflection, this little pool of water about 6 feet wide and 1 foot deep. And we're crawling down right through it. We hit and we splashed it dry. That's when I lost my hold, and she got away. But I'm gonna try to get her again someday.